you know, the best part, this is now applying, okay? So this is application, which is super duper important. But I know that you're applying all the time because I know your coach. Your coach is pushing you to apply all of this all the time. So you're writing down things, you're doing binders, you're being held accountable for, you know, the paperwork she gives you and your stats and all this kind of stuff, on top of your schoolwork and family and friends and life. So this stuff is what we wanted to spend, I wanted to spend, what should be spent most of the time. So now we're going to flow through this pretty quickly. But we're going to go through four exercises to strengthen your talk. I like that. So first, we want to train, you got to train yourself to up your confidence. You have to practice it. It's a learned behavior. It's a skill. Would you agree? Mm-hmm. It's a skill. You mentioned, well, you said basically number one, you're training rigorously, right? So that helps you boost your confidence. Mm-hmm. Because if you hit, for Kiara, you know, some of us just need to see ourselves do it one time. But for you, you need to see yourself do it a bunch of times. And then she can go into the course and do it. And probably pull it off pretty darn well. Enough to get to your goals. And that's what we want. Also, we need to make new goals immediately. Immediately after completing your old goals. Anything that you've completed, you gotta replace it. This goal sheet cannot be empty. Okay, once checked off the list, oh, it's so good, and man, does it feel good. But if you check it off the list, now it's in your memory bank. You gotta put something else down there. And if you don't know what it is, you gotta think about it. You gotta figure it out.
Love that, because in our practices that are tight, you reach a goal, like some of the drills are like, I don't want to say impossible, it's super hard. There's a time limit on those. It's not like get 15 out of 13 out of 15 or whatever, there's a time. How long did it take you? Where did you get after that 15 minutes? If you don't take notes in the summer when you get all your practices back out and go, I'm going to beat this.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, it only took me 13 minutes and I completed it, so it was too easy for me. So some are timers and some are like numbers. So if you beat that and you're not, if you're going home with my practices that are typed out with nothing written on them and nothing written in your notebook that Sophia's dad made us, there's no accountability. So always making new ones, taking notes.
So we have to, okay, and this is a human thing, and I know all of us in this room are capable of having meltdowns. In whatever way we decide to show it. It could be privately, it could be absolutely flipping out emotionally, it could be, I don't know, sending a text. It could be anything, any kind of meltdown. When a larger failure happens, if you have confidence, these meltdowns won't be so big. And this could be a meltdown on the course, friends, it could be just a stress period, it could be something going on with your family. So this is something we really want. And please write it down. If you write down anything, number one is the most important. Because we need to avoid this big emotional stressor. Because if you ever notice anytime you've had a meltdown, that meltdown was more stressful. It wasn't a release. It was more stressful than what happened.
So true.
Because now you own it. And now it got into your bones. So we really want to up our confidence, and only you can do it through working on it. I'm working on it every single day because I'm telling you, everybody's stress is very important. Your stress is as important as my stress. We're just in different worlds. Like, I feel the same things you feel. So my situations aren't any more important or than any one of you. But I have to constantly
personally work on that confidence, because I can't afford to melt down. I can't say one person in this room can afford it. It still may happen, but we can't really afford it to happen. So number two, embrace your position. You have a sense of duty. I don't know if you really think of this for yourself, but you are not just part of this team, but you're a part of a family. You're a part of your friend group that you chose to be a part of. You are a student. You're a sister. Even a half sister. You're a child of your parents. You're a granddaughter. You need to make sure that you embrace your position in the world, because you have a duty. And this all helps us. When you have a sense of duty, it helps your confidence. It helps you feel and respond better. Because I don't know about you, but when you, and I'm going to just go to this team, but you have a position here, and you have a position and a responsibility to each other. And whether you're taking advantage of that or not, I want you to really start thinking about that. Because you all kind of married each other for a little while here in these next few years. So you have to be a good partner to each teammate. And you need to work on things if you're not able to do that right now. But you have to show up for each other, not just in your scorecard, but every day you need to show up for each other.
Sure gets your mind off yourself a lot too.
It does.
About showing up for
it does.
In your poor, pitiful world, and or in your real problems.
Well,
that
and that's a great point, because that brings me to my last real thought about this, is that everything, okay, how do I say this? I want to deliver this right to you so that you understand. But when you have a sense, bear with me here, but I'll get to it, but when you have a sense of duty within this team, like I just said, when you can't just be there for each other when all your ducks are in a row, okay, when everything's going right for you, okay? I don't know. gonna shake it up. And if you answer yes to that question, you better not do it. Do something else, make a different choice. Even if it's on the course and it's about a shot or it's, I don't know, hanging out with people.
I think about, that's the thing, I think about them. My decisions over the summer, where I go, who I mean, everything. Would this affect my team?
So your coach sits here and shows up every single day. She's got a shit ton going on in her life. I got a bunch going on in my life. You've got a bunch going on in yours. But you have to think, is this, you know, whatever decision I'm making here, is it going to affect my team? Because not one of you can drag another down. Because you're all strong, independent women. And you're just getting stronger. So nobody here is gonna butter your bread for your life. Unless they show up for you. And then after school, and after all this is said and done here, you'll walk away with those people. Forever. But it's super important that you're showing up for each other now. So any decisions, again, I just want you to always think. Always ask yourself that question. Some of that helps, you know, get to know your teammates. And I know that your coach is doing some things for that. But spend some time. Take a teammate out for a coffee or something, or hang out. That would be somebody that you didn't really, I don't know. There's no wrong thing. I know that, you know, everybody's kind of thrown together, all very different, and you're gonna have your, you know, your people a little closer than others on the team. But there's nothing wrong with saying, hey, either we got off on the wrong foot, or hey, I'm sorry, or hey, I don't really, you know, let's hang out maybe. You don't have to be best friends, but you do need to get to know each other a little bit.
And seriously, you will be so surprised.
Because all of your strength comes from those around you. And you guys probably spend time, more time with each other than really anybody else right now. Find your pride on the inside. So the one thing I want you to write down, and you can just jot like notes down. You don't have to write out like the entire title of that tournament or something like that. But I want you to think about all the things that you're proud of in your life. I know that's a big question. But what you're proud of. Not what you're happy about. But what you're really proud of, where you've gained some satisfaction from within. It can be a short list. It